So what do you mean by the purity of the nucleic acids, and why this experiment is very important for us? When we talk about nucleic acids, it can be DNA as well as it can be RNA. So any of experiments related to isolation of DNA or RNA from any experimental sources, for the next step of your experiment, before going to that, you must make sure how much pure your isolated nucleic acids are. The reason is because when we are talking about the isolation of nucleic acids, when we are isolating it, there may be some contaminants like proteins. Why proteins? Just now we were discussing about the eukaryotic genome organization, and you know that the nucleosome core particle where you find the DNA wrapped around the histone protein. So when you're isolating the nucleic acids, these proteins also may be present within your isolated sample. Even when you talk about prokaryotic cells, there are some possibility of certain proteins to be present. The second point, remember that during the isolation of the nucleic acids from the samples, we are going to use a solution which is called as the phenol solution. So this phenol also may be present as a contaminant during the isolation procedure. So that is why before going to the next step of your experiment, after isolation, we determine the purity of the sample. Once you determine the purity of sample, then you can determine the concentration of your nucleic acid. So to determine concentration, we can go with the UV visible spectrophotometer, or you can do the colorimetric methods by using DPA for DNA, and you can use arsenol reagent for the RNA solution. So that is all the reason why before going to the next advanced stage of your experiment, we first start with the checking the purity of the isolated nucleic acids. Okay, now coming to the aim, to determine the purity of nucleic acids using UV visible spectrophotometer. Now coming to the principle of the experiment. Point number one, remember that all the pure nucleic acid solutions show absorption maxima at 260 nanometer. So please remember that any nucleic acid solutions, either you are preparing or you are going to isolate the nucleic acids, if they are pure, then they will be having an absorption maxima at 260 nanometer. And this property is typically made use in the spectrophotometric determination of the nucleic acids. Next point, please remember that the ratio between absorbance at 260 nanometer. Now, what is this 260 nanometer? That is a lambda max, or that is the absorption maxima for the nucleic acids. And absorbance at 280 nanometer. What is this absorbance at 280 nanometer? It is a lambda max for the protein. So when you are going to determine the ratio of absorbance at 260 nanometer and absorbance at 280 nanometer for a particular solution, the ratio what you get will provide a good index about the purity of the nucleic acid solution what we have prepared. Okay, now in solution we can say that the pure form of the DNA and RNA typically will have the absorbance ratio between absorbance at 260 and absorbance at 280 about 1.8 and 2. Now 1.8 is a ratio where you're going to calculate the absorbance at 260, absorbance at 280. You separately take these two absorbance values for DNA initially, you calculate it, and if your value is 1.8, then you can say that the DNA solution what you have prepared is pure. Similarly, when you are taking the absorbance at 260 and absorbance at 280 and finding the ratio for an RNA solution, and if you get the value as 2, then we can consider that the isolated RNA or the prepared RNA solution is going to be pure in nature. So that is why we are dependent on this absorbance, because this is the absorbance or the lambda max for nucleic acid. And absorbance at 280 20 is the lambda max for the protein molecules. Okay, if the ratio is found to be less than 1.8 or less than 2, then it can be inferred that the nucleic acid preparation is contaminated either with protein or with the phenol, which we are generally using it for the isolation of the nucleic acid. So these are the four points which we have to keep in mind about the principle. So just only two things. One is the absorption maxima for nucleic acids will be only at 260 nanometer. Why only at 260 nanometer? It is mainly because of the purine and the pyrimidine bases which are present on the nucleic acid. So they have the ring system, purine ring, pyrimidine rings with all the nitrogen atoms present. So that contributes to their absorbance maxima at 260 nanometer. Whereas when you take the proteins, they're going to have the absorption maxima at 280 nanometer. So if you find the absorbance and calculate the ratio, you are going to have 1.8. If you get, it is pure for DNA, and if you get 2, then it is pure solution of the RNA. Now coming to the reagents, what we require for this experiment, there are only two important reagents. First one is the buffer solution, which we call it as a saline citrate buffer solution, or you can simply call it a saline citrate solution. So the concentration is very important. It is 0.15 molar sodium chloride and 0.015 molar of sodium citrate. So we are just taking 876 milligram of sodium chloride and 440 milligram of sodium citrate solution in 80 ml of the distilled water. Mix both the substance thoroughly in the distilled water. Check the pH of the solution. Once the pH has been set to 7, then you can make up the volume to 100 ml. Okay. Now coming to the second component, what we require for the experiment is called as the DNA sample. So you can use DNA sample. Since it is a general topic, nucleic acids, we are going to do with DNA, we'll do even with the RNA also. So this is the concentration of the nucleic acid what we are going to use. So we are going to take 25 milligram of DNA or 25 milligram of RNA was weighed and transferred into a 50 ml standard flask, and the substance was dissolved in saline citrate solution. Later, it was made up to 50 ml with the same saline citrate buffer solution only. Because nucleic acids, you know, DNA and RNA are not soluble in the water, and we are going to prepare them or dissolve them only with the saline citrate buffer solution what we have prepared. Now this is like a stock solution what we are preparing. But after preparation, before taking the readings, it is better we are going to dilute the solution, because the absorbance values, it's not like that you will not get, but you will be getting the absorbance values, and the obtained absorbance values must be always less than, it must be always less than 1. So with this concentration, sometimes we may get a higher absorbance values, that is more than 1. So that's the reason why we are going to dilute the sample. So it is 1:5 dilution. That means from the stock, we will take 1 ml and add 4 ml of the saline citrate buffer solution to it and prepare this 1:5 dilution. We have to do this dilution both for the DNA as well as for the RNA solution. Okay. Now this is the, these are the reagents and how we prepare. I've given to you also, but let us first do with the commercially available solutions, that is commercially DNA and RNA substances available. So we are preparing with that particular concentration. So today we will do with the commercially available solution. In case if you are doing future any of the experiments like isolation of DNA, for those experiments also we will isolate the DNA, we will decant the supernatant, we'll have the pellet of DNA. To that one we have to dissolve it only in the saline citrate buffer solution, and then we can take the absorbance value. Same thing, absorbance at 260, absorbance at 280. You will get some answer, the ratio, you will get the answer. So based on the answer, you can determine how much pure was the DNA which you have isolated. So first thing is that step number one in the procedure, already we have prepared the stock solution, 25 milligram of the nucleic acids in the 50 ml of the saline citrate buffer solution. So from there you're diluting it as 1:5 dilution. It has to be done only with the saline citrate buffer solution. Now step number two, we are going to measure the absorbance possibly only with the UV visible spectrophotometer. So you will require the quartz cuvette. So take two quartz cuvette. In one of the cuvette, you're going to take the blank solution, and the blank solution is going to be saline citrate buffer only, because we have dissolved the nucleic acids only in the saline citrate buffer solution. So it's always better to take the saline citrate buffer only as our blank solution. Whereas to the another cuvette, you can take the required quantity of the diluted nucleic acids. First we will do for DNA, then we will take it for the RNA. Now after taking the liquids in the respective cuvettes, we are going to measure the absorbance of the nucleic acid solutions. First we will measure at 260 nanometer, then we can measure at 280 nanometer against a blank in the spectrophotometer. Then we are going to note down the absorbance values. From the absorbance values, the purity of nucleic acid was calculated with the following equation. That is nothing but absorbance at 260 nanometer by absorbance at 280 nanometer. So with this one, you will get the value. If the values obtained are 1.8 or 2, then we can say that the prepared DNA solution is pure, or the prepared RNA solution is pure. If there you find that the value is less than 1.8 or 2, then we can infer that the nucleic acid solution is not pure. There are some contaminants. Probably the contaminants can be either the protein or it can be the phenol. So this is the tabular column. You can note down this tabular column so that you, when we are taking the absorbance values in the spectrophotometer, you can enter all the values and you can calculate the absorbance at 260 and absorbance at 280. With that, you can determine the ratio. Once you get the ratio, you can finalize the result. So you can, based on the value what you have got for the commercially available DNA and commercially available RNA, you can write the values, and we will see what is the values we are getting, and based on the values we can try to conclude the experimental result analysis. And this is the textbook which we have referred for the experiment of determination of nucleic acids purity by spectrophotometric method. Okay, so
So we will do the experimental part of our experiment by giving you the principle. So the experiment is determination of purity of the nucleic acid by spectrophotometer. So as I said, what are the requirements? Already the solutions are being prepared. This is the stock solution, that is 25 milligram in 50 ml. This is for the DNA. And similarly, this is for RNA. 25 milligram we have weighed and dissolved in the saline citrate buffer solution only. So this is the saline citrate buffer what we have prepared. We have prepared for 200 ml, and out of 200 ml, 50 ml, 50 ml, we have already utilized it for the stock solution preparation. Okay. Now the leftover solution which we are keeping here is for dilution, as well as in the future, if any of the experiment is related with the isolation of DNA, for dissolving that we will require the saline citrate buffer. So we are going to use it back again. So keeping this aside, let us dilute the solution. What is the dilution we have to do? The dilution is 1:5 dilution. So we will label the tubes as 1:5 dilution for the DNA sample, and one more dilution we will do, that is for the RNA. That is 1:5 dilution for the RNA sample. Okay. So now what we will do is that
we will take a beaker. The reason is because just to make sure that I'm able to transfer the or pipette out the solutions from the standard flask, because the micropipette will not go inside. So I'm just going to take RNA and just mixing it one more time thoroughly, and then from here this RNA solution little I am transferring it into a clean beaker, clean dry beaker, from where we will be taking it for the dilution. Okay, similarly I am taking the DNA solution, I am mixing it thoroughly, from there I am going to transfer some amount of the solution into another fresh beaker where I am going to pipette out later for dilution 1 ml. Okay, so now we have to take 1 ml of the solution, the nucleic acid, is it not? So what I'll do is that this is the DNA where we have written 1:5 dilution. This is the DNA solution, 25 milligram and 50 ml. So I am taking initially the DNA solution. Okay, so after taking it, I am discarding the tip. Okay, putting back the solution here. I will do with the next solution, that is going to be the RNA. So this is the RNA solution what we have transferred initially. So from there I am going to take 1 ml into the test tube. Okay, so after transferring the RNA also, I am going to now dilute it only with the saline citrate buffer solution. So how much we are going to take saline citrate buffer solution? We have to transfer now 4 ml for the dilution. So already 1 ml of the DNA we have taken. So I'm going to add 4 times. Once, this is 2 ml. This is 3 ml. And this is 4 ml. So now we have added 4 ml of the saline citrate buffer. So the solution has been diluted in the ratio of 1:5. Similarly for the RNA also, already we have taken 1 ml of the RNA solution. To that we are going to add 4 ml of the saline citrate buffer. So at present I have added 1 ml. So this is the second ml. This is 3 ml. And this is becoming now 4 ml. So we have added 4 ml of the saline citrate buffer now. So we have diluted the samples. Now these diluted samples only we are going to take the absorbance. So one absorbance is at 260, which is a lambda max for the DNA, and the other one is absorbance at 280, where the lambda max is at for the proteins. Okay, so now since we have to take the readings in the spectrophotometer, we will take up all the necessary things in our tray. So I have taken the sample, distilled water, then this is the quartz cuvette. In case if you want any further dilution, let us take the solutions. And you know, for the blank, we will require the saline citrate buffer solution. So that also I am taking over here. Marker, in case if I want any corrections to be done, then the dropper. Yes, we will go to the near the spectrophotometer to take the readings. So the equipment is being switched on, so it will take some time. It is going to take some process. So by the time we take our required solution, okay. So you know the because. We are using the quartz plate because we are going to take the readings in the UV visible region. So you cannot use a glass cuvette. So what we will do is that we will first wash the cuvette. Let me wash the
cuvette, quartz cuvette. You can see this is the quartz cuvette. One side it will be transparent, the other side it will be blurred. Okay, so we have to just wash it with some amount of distilled water so that if any previous dust or contaminants are there, they all will get washed out. Okay. So the capacity of the cuvette, what we have taken is 1 ml only. Okay. So that's a cuvette only we have taken. So after washing it, I'm just trying to remove excess amount of water present in the cuvette. Okay. So now I'll take the solution. So in this one, I will take the unknown solution. Okay. So before taking, let me mix it thoroughly. This sample, what I've taken at present is DNA, diluted DNA. So the absorbance, whatever I'm telling, please make a note of it near the tabular column for DNA only. Okay. So I'm just transferring some amount of the solution because the volume is too less. Be very careful while you're transferring it. Okay. So little bit excess is there. I'm just discarding some. So while you're discarding, you know, cuvette sides, all liquids will be there. So better you clean the outer surface thoroughly so that there are no any droplets. Even your fingerprints, if they are there on the cuvette, they will interfere with the absorbance. So please make sure that very gently by using the tissue paper, you're cleaning on all the sides of the quartz. Okay. So what we have taken in this quartz cuvette is the sample solution, DNA. Okay. So I'm going to place it now inside. So you can see the inside of the spectrophotometer where the samples are going to be placed. I'll just open it and show it to you. So this is the inner compartment where you're going to place the samples. Okay. So this is labeled as 1. This is 2. Okay. So in the 1, we always keep the reference. That is going to be the blank solution. 2 is the slot where you're going to keep your samples. Now 3, 4, 5 is there in case if you have more of samples and at a time you want to take the absorbance, then you can take the quartz cuvette, fill all the cuvettes with the samples, and then you can place it inside, and then you can take the absorbance at a time for 4 different samples also. Since this is DNA, I'm placing it only in the second cell. I have placed the sample. Okay. Now I'll close it. Now we have to fill the second cuvette also, is it not? So I will take the second cuvette, hold it properly. And for this one, we are going to take the buffer solution. So I'll take the buffer. That is the saline citrate buffer solution I will take. So I've used this pipette only for water. So again, I will wash the cuvette once. Rinsing, we will do it so that any previous solutions or dust are there, we were able to remove it. Okay. So just you tilt it so that any leftover droplets are there, they will be coming out. Now I'm going to take in this the saline citrate buffer solution, which is going to be considered as a blank solution. Okay. So I have filled it because the capacity is only 1 ml. It will be sufficient. So I've taken it. So as I told you earlier, throw on all the sides of the cuvette, clean it thoroughly. Okay. So no fingerprints, no drop. So once you have cleaned it, now I'm going to place it in the slot. You see, this is 1. Okay, so this is the place where we are supposed to keep the blank solution or reference. Okay, so I'm just closing it. Now coming to the next part of the instrument, it is connected to the system. Okay, so you have main number of icons with main number of symbols over here. Now this is going to be for the visible. If your absorbance has to be taken in the visible region, this is the lamp which you have to switch it on. But today we are going to take the absorbance only in the UV region. So you can switch on the symbol which is given here as blue color. Okay. So the moment I'm going to click it,
it is giving me the instruction, please wait, because the lamp has to get switched on. So once it is getting switched on, how do I know that it is getting switched on? Here down you will be able to see two blocks are there. If it is visible, when I put the yellow color click here, the visible light will get on. You will be it will be showing it as VIS. That means the visible light inside the equipment is being switched on. If I am going to put UV lamp, then here it will show me the UV. So that indicates that the UV lamp has been switched on. Now you are able to see. You are able to see here.
Yes, ma'am.
See down. See down here. Are you able to see? So this thing, what has been here is the UV. So inside the equipment, the UV lamp has been switched on. Okay. Now after switching on the light, we are going to set the wavelength. So here you have so many lines here, red, different lines are there. So depending on your experiment, which wavelength you want to take, you can select it. Now this single peak indicates to you that you have to take the absorbance only at one single wavelength. If you have multiple wavelength readings, then you can go with the next one. But since I want it for only 260 and 280 nanometer, I am preferring to go with the single wavelength initially. Okay, so just I have to click this one. The moment I click, it will be giving you all these set of readings over here. Now I want only the absorbance, so I am going to click the word absorbance. Already it has been selected, but it is asking me to enter the wavelength. So what is the wavelength we have to take initially? It is going to be the 260 nanometer. Just a type of word,
260 nanometer.
Yes. Okay. Are you all able to see it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, indications is present on the system says that it is showing me that put reference in cell 1. Cell 1 is for what we have used. We are using it for the blank solution. Okay, already I have placed in the first cell, is it not? That is a blank solution. Since I placed it already, I am just clicking here as okay. So now what the equipment is doing, it is taking the reference sample and it will be automatically setting the absorbance at 260 to the wavelength of 0.00. The blank is being going to get set. So once it's now adjusting the wavelengths. We have given the indications as 260. No, so it is going to set it at 260. It has already set. Now it is taking the absorbance of the reference, that is a blank solution. After it is over, then the window will open like this, asking you the serial number, which cell number you have placed the sample. Which cell number did we place the sample in? Means cell number 2. So what to do for that one? You go here on the top, we have this indicator which is red in color. Okay. So this one indicates to you the second well where I placed the sample. Since you have 5 cells, okay, already in cell number 1 reference is there, is it not? So I am not going to do anything over here, but the second cell is the one which is having the sample. So I have to just select the cell number 2, indicating to the equipment that I have placed my sample only in the cell number 2. In case if you are placing a sample in 3, 4 and 5, you have to click all these things also. But today we are having only 2 cuvettes. The first cuvette is a blank, which is kept in the cell number 1. And I've kept sample in cell number 2, 3, 4 and 5. Nothing I've kept. So please keep it empty and give it as OK. So within another few minutes, you will be getting the absorbance values. You can see the values and note it down in your observation note. So this is the absorbance value, what you have got for DNA. What is the absorbance value? Please note it down. It is 1.311. Have you made a note of it?
Yes, ma'am.
This is for DNA 260 nanometer. Okay. Now, once it is done, I will go back again to the wavelength. Now, I will give it as 280 nanometer. Same procedure we have to follow. Okay, so it will first set the wavelength for the blank.
So again, it is reading the reference, that is a blank solution. Again, the second window, but here it's given us selected wavelength is 280 nanometer. So again, I'll go back to the select sample column. Already two selector is been selected. I will just give here as okay. So you should get another absorbance value. You can make a note of it. It is 0.758. Absorbance of the DNA solution at 280 nanometer is 0.758. Okay. So I've given you the absorbance at 260. I've given you the absorbance at 280. Calculate and tell me what is the answer you are getting. By the time I will change the solution.
So here I'm going to discard this solution. I'm going to take only the fresh solution. So because we have taken the previous solution, DNA, I'm going to wash it thoroughly with the distilled water. Okay, so twice or thrice, let me rinse it thoroughly. Now, what we have to do is that I'll just invert it so that if any leftover water is there inside the cuvette, it will come out. Now, I'm going to take the RNA. This is the RNA solution. So, I'm going to take the diluted RNA in the cuvette. So, I'm just trying to shake it. When you are transferring the solution into the cuvette, be very careful that there are no even air bubbles that will also interfere with your vessels. Okay, so transfer it and similar step, clean all the surface sides of the cuvette thoroughly. And then I'm going to place it in cell number 2. Second cell only, I have placed it inside. Okay, so I'm just closing it. We have to follow the same instructions now. There is no any difference here. Go to the single wavelength. Okay, keep it at 250 nanometer. And give it as okay. So it is going to read the reference. That is a blank solution absorbance will be noted down. So now I'll go to the sample number 2. I will just click okay. So it will again give you the reading. So in your tabular column, wherever you can commercially available RNA absorbance at 260, make a note of it. It is 1.752. Please make a note of it. 1.752. This is at 260 nanometer for RNA. Now again, we will go to the wavelength. We will change the wavelength to 280 nanometer. So again, it has, because we have changed the wavelength, again the blank has to reset again by itself. So it will take some time. So once it has set at 280, then it will ask us to give the cell number, in which cell number you have kept the sample. So I have to select it. The procedure is the same. So first, when you give a proper instruction, it will be able to follow it. Now you can see the selected wavelength is 280. So I should now give the cell number. I have placed cell number 2, so I just give OK. I am not selecting cell number 1. The reason is because already we have kept in the cell number 1 as the blank solution, and you can find the reading as 1.107. This is a 280 nanometer, it is 1.107. Okay, I think you have noted down. Yes, students, did you calculate?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the answer you want? That you first tell me.
Ma'am, for purity of DNA, it is 1.729. And for purity of RNA, it is 1.729.